up time.
And I go on to see if my tracks are level. I think they are not, because the ground, when I built the platform, the ground was frozen, and it is built on the soft forest floor. So I think it's now when everything is not frozen anymore, I think it's time to check it and adjust it. But first, some cleanup from the last 2 days of sawing. Starting with a string across all the bunks, and I'm going to put in a piece of wood here and at the other end so I can see that it's flat. It doesn't matter if it's in level in this direction, if it's sloping, as long as it's flat, that's the most important. And then you can go leveling out on the short side. Now the string's in place and tightened up, and I've put two pieces of wood at the under the string at the end, at each end, and then you can measure if it's off. You can't just leave it on this. If one of them are too high, you'll never get a clue. Yeah, you will, but it'll take a long time. Here you can see it's at the 2 centimeter mark, but the next three here, yeah, I can show you. This is 5 millimeter off. It's higher here, and I do think it's because it's attached to two roots that are down there. So I can either lift it a bit in that end and at that end, or I can lower the three in the middle here. I think I'll do that. All of them are loose, and I can start adjusting. Loosen all the nuts and bolts except the first and the last bunk, and inside 1 millimeter. Now it's time to see if the bunks are level. And this one isn't. And I'm gonna control all of them and see if it's this side here that's hanging a bit, and adjust accordingly to that. Yeah, I went through all the bunks with my level, and all of them are slightly low on this side, and I think it's because the platform is on two stumps here and a big rock there, so the forest floor has sunken a bit on this side. Yeah, and up there there's a big rock as well, so that's holding this side in place while this side is sinking a bit. But it's nice, it's the same side all the way. And I'll adjust according to that. It isn't much, it's like a millimeter maybe. Top on the notch on the top before I've done it all. Yeah, all tightened up. Everything is in level in this direction, and the distance between the string and the bunks are inside a quarter of a millimeter, and that's so little, so yeah, it doesn't matter. Yep, ready to go again. Trying to figure out a way to get the logs onto the sawhorse. Well, that one is one, a big one, and it's only been caught, yeah, a week ago, so it's very heavy. But this one I can raise, so I can get this underneath. Hopefully I don't drop anything heavy on my feet or on my hands or arms.
I hope it stays up there. A load of logs, different size and different types. There are birch, asp, oak, even oak logs. All of these, yeah, that big stack there was brought to me by my neighbor today, because I asked him, because he owns a lot of the forest around, yeah. He was the guy who took down the spruce trees in there, and he owns a lot of forest up that way and a lot over there as well. But I asked him when he's deforesting if I can get some of all the leftovers for firewood. And he brought that pile today, and for free firewood brought to the door, I got to saw up these big boys, oak logs, four oak logs and a single spruce log. But I'm going to make them into slabs in 2 and 3 inches thickness in this week, I think. And you can see here, I'll just show you, because this one is gonna, it's too wide for the mill, but I'm gonna mill them in this week. This one is a bit, not in so in the best condition up here, but it's oak, and it'll probably be beautiful when I cut them up. And maybe I can get a slab or two for a table. You never know.